Lance, are you there?
Yes, I am, my friend.
Yeah. I hope you're not too exhausted to be able to share this message with our people, because it really is important.
All right, I'll tell you something. There's a series called Leviathan.
Yes.
That we've sold this series on your program.
Yes.
This spirit that's assigned to twist communication and block technology, and it doesn't want this message right now.
That's right. Praise God, we're going to get
it. We're going to get it. We're going to do it. What I'm saying right now is that prophets prophesied a red wave, false prophets on the left prophesied a blue wave. I never felt comfortable with any wave because I felt we're a house divided as a nation. We can't just assume that Donald Trump, because he's anointed, is going to win this battle. The people of God have got to show up. And you have a unique role, and I have a unique role, and people like us are going to have to lift up our voice like never before. Between now and 2020, Jim Baker, we are going to have to be a voice of awakening to awaken the body of Christ to engagement at a level it has not understood in its personal history. The year 5779 is the Hebrew year. I was in Jerusalem when the rabbis were announcing Rosh Hashanah, the beginning of the new year. The number 9 is a curious number. In Hebrew, a letter is a number and a number is a letter. And the number 9 and the letter 9 represents two things that are entirely antithetical. A serpent in a basket ready to strike. And a woman who is pregnant ready to give birth. What you have is the battle of Genesis. The serpent against the woman and the woman against the serpent. And that battle is being played out in the United States right now. The battle over whether we'll be a sheep or a goat nation during the administration of Cyrus Trump. And the church is pregnant and must push to give birth to this great awakening. For the next 2 years, we are going to be subject to that Leviathan Trump, just like the broadcast tonight, trying to interrupt us. That spirit is going to be working through journalism. It's going to be working through legal structures. It's going to tear apart and attempt to tear apart the Trump family, the Trump business, in order to go into tax returns that are over a decade old. Just like a Stormy Daniels and a Russia investigation, we're going to have our minds subjected to the irrational assault on the legitimacy of a presidency that Democrats to this day have not been able to accept. And as that happens, I prophesy it will backfire. In the same way that Republicans went after Bill Clinton to impeach him, the Democrats are going to attempt Donald Trump, and the nation actually will not engage in their narrative. But it's going to be our two-year window. We're going to have to expand on two. The gospel is going to have to begin to preach more effectively, and we're going to have to win more souls and disciple them. And we're going to have to get the church that is dormant, that is asleep, the 50 million of us that are capable of voting and registered to vote, to actually show up in the battle. A lot of pastors don't want what you're saying, Jim, because it unsettles the status quo, puts them in the crosshairs of potential controversy. But we've got to keep the heat on because it's a grassroots revival. And we have more Christians in Congress today, even with the exchange of office, than we've ever had before. There's a pastor that ran for office in the 9th District of Carolina, who got elected tonight. Mark Harris? I interviewed him. Went from the church right into Congress, and they tried to take sermons and twist them to make him sound like he was a male misogynist. But it didn't work. And we've got good people on the Hill right here where I'm at right now. We have got to create a groundswell of organized and aligned communication that will expose the corruption of what the enemy is doing in America and begin to bring people over in alignment with the better future of America. And it's going to be a battle that the church is the front lines of. And I believe you're on the front lines of it along with me, Jim. 5779 is the year when the pregnant church gives birth to a move that will crush the serpent's head. That's what I'm saying.
Thank you so much for being with us tonight.